Yespmed. Because of the day that's in it, this is called Beautiful Stranger. I remember you being the beautiful stranger I just had to get to know, the one I knew I couldn't let go. Held hostage by a smile, entangled in your laughter, turning my head with a mere turn of your head. You, the beautiful stranger who became my beautiful wife. And this is called, I've kissed Jan all over, from the tips of her toes to her popliteal fossa to her philtrum. We've now got a certificate in the art and craft of kissing, as it happens. So this is called, of all the kisses and all the worlds, and she has to walk into mine. I kissed you in Islip and Liss, then once again in Swatling, Shipton and Pershore. Wherever I kissed you, I only ever wanted to kiss you more. I kissed you in Amberley and Arundale. Once I kissed you in Swale and Sway. I kissed you all over in many various places that I cannot remember today. I only remember the kisses scattered all over England, refusing to fade away. And long before Scotland thought, Jesus, we better get out of this, or long before Brexit was even a glint in a buffooning Boris's eye, I wrote this. It's called The Pursuit of Happiness. The original Declaration of Independence had the pursuit of property. But they scratched out property and put in happiness. So, the pursuit of happiness. We declare this our bedroom, an independent dominion. Secede from the United Kingdom and the Commonwealth of Nations, although still enjoying our European unions. As a republic of love out on our own, our newfound land, or as Don had done, a currency of kisses, our national tongue caresses, needing nothing but the other to complete our independence, flying the flag of happiness in this our brave new world of love. And you heard me mention the philtrum. Does anybody know where your philtrum is? Nope. Right. The poem will tell you and explain what a philtrum is. Love Charm, it's called, which is another name for philtrum. I kiss your philtrum and you moan. I lick a tiny trickle of sweat from it. I know it has no apparent function and survives between your delightful nose and your delicious upper lip. But what of it? A kiss fits so neatly into it and leads to lips and lips upon lips, ending in an erotic ellipsis. I love to look upon it as the indent left by the finger of God, or where an angel shushes the yet to be born, teaching it to forget all it has learned in the world of the womb. I kiss again your philtrum, a kiss fits so neatly into it. This is called I Like to Say Your Name. I like to say your name when you're not here, turn you into sound, conjure you out of thin air, so that you appear before me dressed in sound only, memory sketching in the rest of you, as if sound was just an outline and love colours you in, adding the voice last so I can hear you say, hello you. And there you are, as present can be. I like to say your name when you're not there. And this is called watching the, we're going to change now. This is called watching the window. She smiles at one and all, but mostly to herself. I love to watch the large TV set, she announces to no one. She points to the window. It only shows bird programs. Outside, the birds flock around the feeder. The new nurse smiles and has to stifle her laughter. But sometimes strange humans come and knock and scare my birds away. New nurse turns the sheets down. Oh, I complain, but it doesn't do no good. Oh dear, Miss New Nurse explains yet again. That's your family, see, waving at you and holding up signs. The clock ticks a very audible tock. Look, see, I love you, Gran. Oh, and isn't that nice from the little one? She lets her tea go cold, takes her glasses off. I've never seen them before, and why the masks? Now, Natalie, I have told you about COVID before. She whimpers, oh, nurse, make them go away, please. It brings on my asthma. I'm put back on the bird channel. Now, one of the things I used to do with the kids was I'd be taking the roll in school and I'd say, okay guys, write down your names. And they'd all write down their names. I thought, isn't he supposed to be calling the roll? And I said, now look at your names very carefully and write them backwards. So I gave them all backwards names. And then they loved the backwards names and wanted to be called by a backward name. And my name, when you spell it backwards, well, this is what the poem is about. And then I get them to write stories about these imaginary Martian alien people that they'd become just by this process. It's called Donald Dempsey Indeed. Llanod Yespmed, he squinted at my driver's license. It's pronounced Clannad, I said with extreme exasperation. You're not from these here parts, are you, fella? He drawled dryly, squinting closer, firstly at me and then back at my ID. I'm of Welsh Turkish extraction, but I was born on Venus, I explained as if to a little kid. He snorted, a tiny trickle of snot yo-yoing up and down his hairy left nostril. If you were to spell your name backwards, it would spell Donald Dempsey. I was not amused. You know, that crazy hairy Irish shirtling poet dude? I'm not him, I fumed. All right, keep your antennas on, jeez. He handed me back my ID, tipped his hat, wiped his nose across his sleeve. Welcome to Mars, you drive carefully now. I stepped on the rocket boosters, left them eating my stardust. Bloody customs, I yelled to myself. Ha! Donald Dempsey, indeed. And there's a famous song called Carrick Doon, and you'll hear about it in the poem. And I exist in the song as I exist in reality. And the river was the river below my uncle's farm. So I was amazed that this song contained not only me, but my uncle's farm and river as well. So it's called Singing the River. Walking with my uncle was never the ordinary process of perambulation in order to get from point A to point Z. We would sing our way west into the field as if to tame it, soothe it with sound. On Carrick Down, the heat is brown, we'd sing to it. The clouds are dark or ardently, the grass listening with its thousand ears, and the field would swoon and fall down to the river at its border, which, as it happened, was the real-life river of the song, to kiss the slumbering Onibwe, as if he had sung it into existence. And we would roll ourselves down over and over until we arrived at its dizzy waters, dangling our toes in pure song. And now, with a quick uncle wink, let's walk home backwards. And backwards home we'd go, just for the laugh of it. The yes of it. Confusing cows and a few scattered clouds. Trees and hedges tiptoeing away from us, proclaiming, is it Magyar or what? And the next day, off we'd go, walking eyes closed in a darkness of our own making, to sing its song to the river. The river chuckling over stones to itself. And the next day would be backwards with eyes closed, led along by our own laughter and the odd mystified moo. Farewell, we'd tell the sleepy river. Farewell, leaving it dreaming in a sunset. Shh, shush the footsteps. Shh, shush is walking backwards. And Donald swore, I or, he'd part no more, a storm a cree. Shh, shh, shh. And by God, I loved that river, those times. That was a love poem to a river, don't often get that on Valentine's Day, my uncle, and a little boy who I used to be. So I often thought about this river, I'd love to go back there, but somebody else owns it now and I can't. So this is called Welcome. There was a knock in the door. I opened it. The river stood there dripping all over the welcome mat. It had dragged along birds, trees, bits of sky, an old worn summer. Hi, it rippled. Remember me? Sure, I said. You said you would never forget me. How could I said. It grinned like that summer all over again. Come in, I said. It hung up the trees and sky on the hat rack. It sat in the bath, talking of this and that. Wow, I thought, still listening to the river, talk of all the times we spent together. Memory sure does play some funny tricks on the mind. Well, it said, I guess I better be going. It put on back on the trees and birds wore the sky at a jaunty angle. You haven't changed a bit, I said, kissing it goodbye. You've got very old, it smiled. So very, very old. I laughed. I'm not that small boy I was. It wished me well. The door closed, its footsteps lost in time. I was missing it already. And finally, this is called A Poet's Work. I used to be sick a lot, and I was at home with my mum, and I would do all the housework that she'd done and live her life, and I loved being with her and everything like that. So this is about writing poetry, but it's cross-pollinated with my mother's morning efforts. A Poet's Work. Oh my God, is that the time? 12 o'clock and not a poem in the house written. Quick, wash those adjectives. Oh, quick, bathe those verbs. Feed those nouns. Have you adverbs gone back to bed? Come on, smile. Like a simile. No, don't wear the same metaphors you wore yesterday. And so with a little playful smack on its BTM, the poem is sent off into the world. See ya. Be good. A poet's work is never done. Thank you.